שלמה ליהושע פרג' בן לינדה. This is a special siyum, because as the rabbi say, first of all, as the rabbi say, if I don't do it, some people will have to fast, the Bechorot. And second thing, this is a special siyum, because this is the siyum of Daf Yomi, that many thousands of people finish that Gemara of Chulin today. And also that a little funny thing is, usually when you finish the Daf Yomi, you start the new Masechet. Guess which Masechet is coming up now?
Bechorot.
Masechet Bechorot, which is in Ta'anit Bechorot. So we do the siyum. Amar Rabbi Yosef, ilmale de rasha acher le'ai kera kerabi oka Yaakov bar Berata lo chata. Mai chaza, ika de amre ki'ai ma'aseh chaza. ויקה דאמרה ישנה דרבי חוספית המתורגמן חזר. דאבה מוטלת בהשפע. אמר פה שהפיק מרגליות הלכו חפה, והוא לא ידע למען ייטב לך בעולם שכולו טוב, ולמען יאריכון ימיך בעולם שכולו ארוך. The Gemara is finishing with the case of רבי אלישע אחר, that he rebels against the Torah. So the Gemara asked what he saw. They said one of the things that he saw is one of the 10 הרוגי מלכות, the one that was killed on Kiddush Hashem, the Romans ripped his tongue and they threw it in the trash. So he said, a mouse that expressed pearls of wisdom is now making a dust, so he rebels against the Torah. He said, where is the reward? We'll go back to it shortly. Masechet Chulin is a Masechet of 142 pages. I wouldn't expect from a Masechet like that talks about dinim of kashrut, of shechita, of basar v'chalav, to bring us some very fundamental and principles in the Judaism. Yet, it brings some of these things, and I will try to explore two or three of them. We go back to that case of the Rabbi Elisha Acher. He thought there is no reward for doing good. Because the Torah says, "Leman itav lach, leman yarechun yamecha." But the principle of the Torah, they told him, "You didn't hear what Rabbi Yaakov said. For mitzvot in this Torah, in this olam, there is no reward. Why? Because mitzvah is something spiritual. It's too high of a degree to get a reward for it in this olam, which is all materialistic." You get the reward the olam shekulo tov and the olam shekulo aroch. It means in the world that is entirely long and entirely good. But if you ask yourself, we see that the Torah is full of promises of good, of reward. You open the book of Devarim, it's plenty of blessing, and on the other side also of curses, the one that doesn't do it. Harambam explained that all these promises is Hashem telling us this is not a reward. This is enabling us, when you do this, the mitzvah in simcha, Hashem will unveil us to do the mitzvot in an easy way. You'll have more time, and He will bestow on us all His blessing. But this is not the reward. The reward is only in the Olam Haba. Another principle is, there is a perek here that deals with the Elu Terefot, which is the kosher animals and unkosher animals. So one, the sign of the kosher animals, as we know, is that they chew their cud and they have a split tooth. So when it talks about the animals that are not kosher, it talks first of all about the camel. It says, "Hagamal ki ma'ale gerahu v'parsai no mafriz." He chews his cud, but he doesn't have a split tooth. First of all, it gives you the sign of the kosher animal. The other way with the chazir, with the pig, it tells you ki ma'ale ki ma'ale ki mafris parsahu v'gerayno eno ma'ale. It means he has a split tooth, but he doesn't chew his cud. Now, when the Torah used the word about the kosher sign, it says ki ma'ale gerahu ki mafris parsahu. It used the word who. Who in Hebrew is an exclusion word. It means only this animal will, the Torah is telling you, only this animal will have the kosher sign. And only the other animal will have also only the kosher sign. Any other animal besides these two, as a matter of fact, there are four, not two, If you see a kosher sign, one of them, you don't have to check the second one. Automatically you will have it. The Torah is guaranteeing you that if you see one sign in any other animal, you don't have to check the other one. Now the question is asked, how Moshe knew these things? What, he was a scientist or something? This is a, you know, something bigger exploration, but it shows us about the truthfulness of the Torah, about the emet of the Torah. When the Torah is from Shamayim, only the Torah from Shamayim can guarantee you such a thing. To tell you, if you see an animal, if you know that it's not a camel and it's not a pig, if you see one kosher animal, you don't have to, kosher sign, you don't have to check on the other sign. Point number three, I pay attention to it. There was like in the same period, Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi seemingly had an innocent statement. He said like that: all the creation that Hashem created was created in their fully mature state. It said, "Kol ha-bereot shebara HaKadosh Baruch Hu nivreu mekomatam ve-betzivyonam." As the pasuk say, "Vayechul ha-shamayim ve-haaretz ve-chol tzevaam." He said, "Don't read tzevaam, dikru betzivyonam." Again, he's saying, all the creation that were done in the 6 days were built like in the final stature. It means when Hashem created, let's say, the mountains and the valleys and the oceans, He built it in a way, in a mature state. It means it could have been he created something that is maybe 10 billion years. When He created the man was not created like a baby. It was like already in a mature state. Now this thing, this is an amazing statement, it sheds a lot of light on seemingly there is a contradiction about what is the age of the universe. We know that the world is 5,772, right? According to our religion. But you read, you open books and you read, scientists say 15 billion, someone say 10 billion, someone say 20 billion, kola mosif mosifim lo. We get a little lost. But now with this statement of Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi, an innocent statement, it, to me, I don't know about you, but to me it sheds a lot of light. It shows you that when Hashem was creating in the 6 days, He created a creation that was in a full mature state. It means, I don't have a problem. He could have created something of 10 billion or 15 billion, whoever wants to, you know, let the scientists take care of it. When He created, now, when we're counting 1,572 years, this is the creation of the man. As we say in Rosh Hashanah, Hayom Harat Olam. This is the day that Adam was created. We are not talking about the age of the universe. We see a hint to that in Sefer Devarim, when Moshe, in Parashat Hazinu, he tell Bnei Israel, Zechor Yemot Olam, Binu Shenod Or Vador. The beginning of the Pasuk is talking about remember the days of the world. And in the end of the Pasuk, it says, understand the years. There is two things, there is in history. There is something that called natural history. Natural history is the history of the, you know, the skies, the moon, the stars, mountains, valleys, ocean. Someone has to be, you know, impressed about this creation. So Moshe tell Bnei Israel, you want to be close to Hashem? Look at all this in the natural history of the world. Get impressed. If you are not getting impressed from that, Binu Shenod Dor Vador, there is another kind of history which is called human history. Human history is the history of mankind, events that happen in the world. You tell them, look at the event that happened during the years, how Hashem controlled them. Each one can look and read the history about event, and you see the hand of Hashem in each one of them. So he tells them, if you are not impressed from natural history, look at human history. It means he's dividing the pasuk to two. He's talking about the 6 days of creation, which is really natural history, and then about the history of human being, about what we say. There is a story, true story, like maybe 20, 25 years ago, There was a scientist, Schreiber, I think, was the Nobel Peace Prize for Physics, and another professor of chemistry. They were walking next to the wall of the old city, to Jerusalem. So the professor asked the Dr. Schreiber, "What do you think about God?" So the professor answered him, said, "You know, we are scientists. Leave God to the rabbis. We are scientists. But, you know what? I'm impressed about the Jewish people coming back to Eretz Israel." So look at this guy. He really was not impressed so much from the natural history, but he was impressed from Jewish coming back to Eretz Israel. He was not impressed with Italian people eating pizza in Rome. He was not impressed in Greek people drinking moussaka in Athens. What impressed him? Jewish people eating falafel in Jerusalem. Why is that? Because we were not supposed to be there. We look at all this great empire. The Persian Empire, the Egyptian Empire, the Roman, the Greeks, all these big great empires of the world disappear from the world. But we, the smallest nation, are still alive and kicking with full cylinder. So again, we as Jewish people, we're supposed to get impressed from natural history, from all the creation of Hashem, but also we have to look at the event of life and to see that the hand of Hashem is always lying there. We are approaching Passover in 2 hours. This is the most clear indication how the hand of Hashem is controlling the events in the world. If not, we will be still Avadim Ayinu LeParo BeMitzrayim. Only by the hand of Hashem, we were able to be free and to celebrate this holiday. So, Yehi Ratzon that we start and finish new Masechtot, and Chag Kasher V'Sameach LeKulam. הדרן הלך מסכת חולין, והדרך דעתן הלך מסכת חולין, והדרן הלך לא נשא מנך מסכת חולין, לא נשא מנך, לא בעלמא דן ולא בעלמא דעתן. הדרן הלך מסכת חולין, והדרך דעתן הלך מסכת חולין, ודעתן הלך לא נשא מנך מסכת חולין, לא נשא מנך, לא בעלמא דן ולא בעלמא דעתן. הדרן הלך מסכת חולין, והדרך הלך, דעתן הלך מסכת חולין, ודעתן הלך לא נשא מנך מסכת חולין, לא נשא מנך, לא בעלמא דן ולא בעלמא דעתן. יעתב, יהי רצון מלפניך, אדוני אלוהינו ולא אבותינו, שיהיה תורתך אמונתנו בעולם הזה, שתהיה עמנו לעולם הבא, חנינה ורבפה, רומם ורבפה, נחמן ורבפה, אחי ורבפה, אבא מרמיר ורבפה, רפם ורבפה, אחיש ורבפה, צורך ורבפה, אדם ורבפה, דרוב ורבפה, הערבנו אדוני אלוהינו את דברי תורתך בפינו, ופי אדמך בישראל, ונהיה כולנו, אנחנו בצאצאינו, בצאצאי צאצאינו, בצאצאי עמך בית ישראל, כולנו יודע שמך ולומדי תורתך לשמע, מועבדתך כבן מצוותיך, כי לעולם היא לי, תהיי דוד, לבית דוד וחוקיך, למען לא אבוש, לעולם לא אשכח פקודיך, כי בא מחייתני, ברוך אתה אדוני, תמידני חוקיך.